I think you all mentioned this, so this isn't anything new, but I would really, it's probably the hardest thing, but I would really endorse pushing, especially at the steering committee level, regional solutions. I know you've all said why it's so hard, but until we can make a dent there, and if it means being, going Massachusetts word or whatever, you know, some of you have seen the comments, for example, from elected officials in Marin County, where they literally say we should be exempt from building any housing. I'm Mary, I'm sure you have some thoughts on that. I found that truly astonishing, but also candid. In any event, you can certainly endorse efforts to push upstream on that issue, because it's really important.
Thank you very much. My name is Pat Eklund, and I'm elected official with the city of Novato. Michael, it's good to see you again. I was not going to say anything today, but I could not let Bill's comment go without a response. That comment is furthest from the truth, and I am urging this committee not to make judgments on specific localities based on hearsay, but look at the facts. The city of Novato, we used 100% of our redevelopment money, and Michael knows about this, to build 600 affordable housing units in our town. 300 ownership, 300 rental. We've done a lot more than that. We've done more than a lot of cities throughout the Bay Area. There's no question that there's a housing crisis, but all of us has a responsibility. Not only cities and counties, but also the special districts. Schools own property. They should build housing for their teachers and administrators on their property. Water districts, sanitary districts, all the special districts, college districts. There's a lot of land out there that is dedicated for other purposes where you could possibly build worker housing. Also, business has a responsibility. I'm a firm believer that business, if they're going to create jobs, they have to build housing for their employees. And, you know, I look at the Google site and I've toured it. Why didn't they add a different a layer or two of housing for the people who work there so that they didn't have to commute 2 or 3 hours? I totally agree with Steve Levy's comment about carrots and not sticks. We need some tools. I'm running for re-election this year, and I have been on the city council for 22 years. I have never seen as many vacant homes that are just sitting there than I have over the past 2 decades. Why is that? That's because mom and dad passed and the kids are living elsewhere if they want to hold on to the house. So I go down to the assessor's office to find other contact information. We have no tools to do it, so I'm contacting them as an elected official trying to convince them to rent that house. We have no tools. So I have other ideas. We need incentives to keep affordable housing units. Those 600 affordable housing units, I'm sorry, Michael, but on a split vote on a city council, and I was the no, we lost some of those because of the downturn in the economy. And so it costs us money in order to manage those housing units. And there's no incentive for cities to keep those, because once you count them, that's it. But it's a huge responsibility on our part. So I have other ideas, but you know, fundamentally, this whole cost of process, this is my first meeting, I'm gonna attend the steering committee, but what I can see right now is that there's a fundamental flaw. And the fundamental flaw is most of the 101 cities of the Bay Area are not the big cities. They're the small and the middle. Where are they? Where are they around this table? I see a planner or two, but you have no elected officials. You know, and I have a lot of passion for affordable housing. Novato has. And I just really wish that people would not be judgmental. Look at the facts and really think about the practical aspect of implementing this. Thank you very much for giving me a little bit more extra time.